everybody, what's up? It's your girl Ronnie Blue and I am back for Basketball Wives. Okay, ladies decide to take a trip. Okay, we celebrating Evelyn and her eggs being popping, bitch, because y'all know that's all we talking about as far as Evelyn is concerned, is that fucking IVF, y'all, in vitro fertilization. That's what it's saying for, IVF. Somebody put IVF one time and I'm like, oh no, honey. I don't think that's right, but I didn't want to say it because I'm like, bitch, I kind of thought she was saying that at first too. And then I had to think about it. I'm like, no, she going to have three vitro. Okay, no, so it's IVF. Yeah, I had to think about that myself. So I'm just letting y'all know right now. All right, now we got to go through the normal bullshit whenever we go on a trip, okay? Who's going to have the best room? Well, Shawnee, Tammy, and Evelyn got there first, so they got the three rooms on the main level that are the best rooms, and there is like a dungeon that goes downstairs, and there's a huge bedroom with a bathroom and a little living area, and then there's a blow-up bed right on the side of the other bed, and Kristen was the next person to get there, so she was like, oh no, bitch, we gonna get this blow-up bed out of my room. And then down the hall there was some bunk beds. Now I don't know if y'all know, but the Bonnie girl, who we don't even know why she's even on the show right now, we have no idea why she's there on a trip. Okay, she came, and Malaysia and Jackie came also. Now, I don't know what the sleeping situation is going to end up being like, because we completely forget about that shit once Malaysia and Jackie get there and they bitch out about the beds. And, oh, I am not sleeping here and I'm not sleeping there, but we never saw where anybody was really fucking sleeping, okay? But everybody gets there. They play a little drinking game, Never Have I Ever. And the only reason we bringing this up is because Never Have I Ever slept with a married man and bitch still got three fingers up. And then she move it to this side so Tammy don't see it. But Tammy like, bitch, I can see that. Okay? You fucked my husband. Put your fucking finger down, bitch. Okay? They put on a commercial break, tried to act like it was a big deal. She put the finger down just because, even though, okay, look, let me explain. They were about to get a divorce. Okay, they already filed, but I'm like, bitch, people decide to get divorced every day. And when they redraw the paperwork, they still fucking married, bitch. So as far as I'm concerned, he was still married. It does not matter that, you know, that Tammy was a non-motherfucking factor. They still was married, bitch. So you need to put the finger down. And she did put the finger down. It wasn't a big deal. We joked about it, all right? Everybody had a good time. The next morning, we tell Kristen that, look, girl, we're going to have somebody come and have a little makeover. And she should have said we're going to do makeovers for everybody if they want them. Okay? That's what she should have said in order to make Kristen not feel bad. Or maybe she should have pulled this aside. I don't know. But Kristen felt like she was kind of being ganged up on and judged by everybody. And she got emotional and she walked away. And Jackie went and followed behind her. And somewhere in their conversation, Jackie lied and said she didn't know this was going to happen. Because I'm sure Kristen felt like, why didn't you give me the heads up that this is what everybody was talking about? Talking about how I can't dress. Talking about my body type. Whatever. Then the bitch Sanaya comes. Sanaya is a stylist. Now, I don't know where y'all got this hood rat from, but y'all need to send her back, okay? Return to fucking sender. I don't like the bitch. She don't belong on the show. Sanaya comes off like a fake-ass Marlo, okay? Like, just extra as fuck. Think she's so on it, whatever, okay? Now, Kristen tried to be a team player. She took her back to the room, and then she starts to shade the girl about how, you know, I can show you how to ball on a budget. And it's like, the bitch is not broke, okay? This has nothing to do with money. This has to do with the fact that she had her miscarriage. She had carried her baby to 4 or 5 months, so she had gained weight. And now she is going through depression on top of the fact that her body is changing and she's trying to get back to a normal size and no baby being there. There's a lot going on with Kristen, and she is feeling betrayed by Evelyn because she feels like Evelyn knew what was going on with her, and now you still want to try to make fun of how I dress or how I look. Now, I understood where Kristen was coming from, but I want her to put everything in context. If the bitches on the show ain't gonna talk about how you look, everybody on social media watching this fucking show is gonna talk about how you look. And the first time we seen you, the first scene, you looked a little disheveled, you had a little back fat. Bitch, look, I understand. I ain't got no little bitty waist no more neither, okay? I totally get it. But guess what? I don't wear skin tight clothes. And I'm damn sure not gonna show up for taping with my ponytail a little not all the way right. You know what I'm saying? And that's how she looked. So it's like, somebody is trying to help you, because this is going to eventually become an issue when everybody starts talking about how your ass can't dress and how you look all the time, because they gonna do it. You on a reality show, bitch. Let's keep this in perspective, okay? So I did feel like maybe it was not executed properly, but I did feel like Evelyn had good intentions. I don't think she was trying to embarrass the girl. I don't think she was trying to hurt the girl's feelings. But the girl, Sanaya, was, okay? She started to talk about, you know, when she came, because Evelyn and other ladies came downstairs to see what was going on with the little makeover, and she makes a comment about how she read a meme that said, you know, you're not ugly, maybe you just broke. And she was trying to be funny, but it's like, this woman is in a very sensitive place right now. She's crying. Evelyn's crying because she's crying. And you sitting up there talking about, maybe she not ugly, she's broke. Bitch, what is wrong with you? See, you can tell that she the type of woman that'll fuck somebody else's man. She even made a comment about she wanted her to dress ghetto chic like her. You know, I take your man, bitch, and all this type of shit. First of all, your fucking ass look too old to have that type of mentality. Grow the fuck up. I want to know who the hell is hiring you to style them, because you have no professionalism. And that's what Kristen told us. She was like, you're not professional at all, like making all these little jabs and shit, and it goes in one ear and out the other, because apparently Sanaya does not remember saying that the girl didn't have any style and that she was broke. I never said you didn't have any style, bitch. You just said it 2 minutes ago, okay? Evelyn just walks away and goes outside to see how Kristen is doing, because Kristen walks away and she goes and talks to Malaysia and the other girl. We don't know why she there. Went and talked to them about what was going on and how the girl was throwing jabs, and Evelyn comes and she's like, look, I never meant for that to happen. This was not how I envisioned this going. I am so sorry. And Sanaya comes out there and she's like, look, I don't want it to be a problem or anything like that, okay? I don't want it to be an issue. And you know, nobody was calling you fat, and it's like, but bitch, you was being shady, okay? And you a hard, non-emotional ass bitch that don't need to be on this show. You need to take your big ass on somebody else's hood ass show, okay? Because Basketball Wives ain't the fucking one. Call Bravo and see if they got some of the hood show to put you on. Because, no, bitch, I don't even want to see you on. Matter of fact, yeah, put on Love and Hip Hop. That's a little bit more her speed. But see the way she acting? Oh, my God. Take that bitch back wherever y'all found her. I don't know why they let her stay after everything that happened. Kristen's fucking crying. Evelyn apologizes to her over and over again and tells her, look, I never wanted it to be like this. I will never offer you a makeover again. And if I do, I will do my research to make sure it is not some hood rat ass bitch that's coming here trying to make you feel bad about yourself because she doesn't know how to deal with a client that isn't so open to a change, okay? Jackie asked her not to leave, okay, because she was like, Jackie, won't you let me make you over? And Jackie was like, no, girl, I'm all right. And Shawnee was like, but Jackie, your whole areola is out right now. And then Sanaya starts touching her titties and flirting with her. And now all of a sudden, these two bitches have fell in love. Okay, they even both got camouflage on. Okay, whatever. I don't like it. I don't like Sanaya. I don't know why she had to stay. I was pissed off for Kristen that she was staying there. They go out to dinner. She sits there and tells them how she was fucking some dude that was major in the game, that was the biggest star in the game. And some people are saying Allen Iverson, and some people are saying LeBron. Now, I'm kind of more leaning towards LeBron just because, bitch, you had to be out the country in the past couple of years for it to be Allen Iverson. Like, Allen Iverson hasn't played over here in a minute. Am I right? Like, last time I checked. But either way, LeBron is a person that I would think of also because Asia's ass, who knows Sanaya, and we're not going to find this out until next episode. I saw it in the previews that Sanaya and Asia, who is Kristen's sister, Asia, who is also D-Wade's baby mama, that's the woman he had his break baby with when he was with Gabrielle Union before they got married, okay? So it makes sense to me that if we sitting courtside and all of that type of shit, that she was probably fucking with LeBron James. She said that she fucked him 2 days before he got married, and that's when they kind of ended it. And that sounds about right. LeBron seems like the type of dude that probably was cheating on you, but once he got married, he was like, okay, I gotta cut it out, because now I'm marrying her. And they had 3 kids, and if last time I checked, I do believe that LeBron has 3 kids with his old lady. I'm not sure, but I do know it's more than one. Y'all let me know down in the comments. So I'm just on the fence. But either way, that doesn't change anything. Shawnee and everybody else at the table who are like the wives and girlfriends of men who have been, you know, cheated on by these women like her that are fast and loose, don't give a fuck, talking about I love him, but you don't want to be with him. You are okay with being a side piece, okay? Like, you have no respect for his relationship. That's not your business and all of that. Everybody at that table should have wanted to fuck you up, including Jackie. But Jackie's sitting over there kikiing with your fucking ass, all right? You're a homewrecking ass bitch with a bad attitude that I don't know how you got on the level that you have gotten on unless you was fucking all of them niggas you was styling. I'ma just be real. This is what I'm seeing coming off of you, the energy that you're giving off to us, okay? Because I know I'm not the only one that's looking at Sanaya like, please send this bitch back to wherever the fuck y'all found her, okay? Oh, slutty ass, ignorant ass bitch, okay? Send her back. Don't like her. Yo, I don't know why Malaysia did this, okay? But because they had a whole conversation in which Tammy and Shawnee, let it be known, don't nobody miss Brandy, don't nobody want to see Brandy, don't nobody want to be around Brandy, okay? Malaysia sitting up there talking, I see you guys chemistry and it makes me wish, you know, miss my B or whatever. And it's like, nobody cares. Nobody wants to be around her, right? 24 hours later, Malaysia goes to the bathroom when they having dinner and comes back with fucking Brandy. Tammy like, bitch, I know I just told you I don't want to be around this bitch. Shawnee turns to Tammy and said, do you want to leave? And she was like, yeah. So I guess because Evelyn is like, at the end of the day, I mean, these my two friends. These are two bitches I came with. I don't know the bitch, but I came with them. So if them, you know, them two getting up, I got to get up too. So they all get up and walk off. And instead of just leaving it alone and being like, well, fuck them hoes then. What y'all doing? What's going on? They proceed to follow her. Brandy's like, what is the problem? I mean, what's the problem? Are you intimidated? What's the problem? And Malaysia's like, oh, well, Tammy feels like you antagonized the situation between her and Duffy, which you kind of did, especially when Tammy explained it. She was like, I was watching, okay, how Brandy was like, girl, you better say something, okay? You better represent for Dallas. After they went around the table a couple of times and Duffy and Tammy had both said they were fine. And then Brandy like, girl, you better think, you better say something. Now, like I said last review, I don't think another grown ass woman can make another grown ass woman do anything. But somebody pointed out something very, very crucial that I forgot. Even though Malaysia was talking all of that shit, when Brandy called her, she sure did hop her fucking ass in a Jeep and come over, you know, come over somewhere to fight Angel Brinks. And she didn't know what the fuck was going on. So she said something and you jumped, but I thought she was a grown ass woman too, bitch. Like, I'm just really confused about this with the kitty clicking, you know, shit that they got going on where we gotta fight bitches every time something go down because that's my friend, that's my B, and I'm her B. And if I'm here, then Brandy Maxill's gonna be here. And it's like, well, bitch, you don't need to be nowhere then, okay? Because don't nobody like your friend. Don't nobody like your friend. I'm sorry. I don't care what nobody say. I personally don't like Brandy. I'm over Brandy. I'm tired of their little twosome. I would have liked to see Malaysia without Brandy. But since I can't have Malaysia without Brandy, bitch, you can take Malaysia back too, as far as I'm concerned. Because you got an attitude or you seem so disinterested when she not there. Like, you can't, you know, like, you can't have fun and be a part of the shit when it's just you. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know, y'all. If anything, that weekend was not boring. So I don't know what the fuck Malaysia was talking about and why she needed Brandy to be there so bad. I don't know. But I understood why Tammy and them walked away. I told you I don't fuck with her, and you still gonna bring her around me. If you want her to come and eat with y'all, that's fine. But I'm about to get the fuck up and walk away. And everybody was like, that was so petty. And I'm like, it could be petty. If I don't want to be around a bitch, I don't want to be around her. Call her what the fuck you want to. Call it petty, call it stupid, I don't give a fuck. If I don't want to talk to you, if I don't want to have no motherfucking conversation with you, and I decide to get up and walk off, and my friend's like, well, bitch, we came with her, so we walking off too, then that's what the fuck we doing. Following me ain't about to make the situation no better, okay? I was just like, if this ain't one stupid fucking situation after another on Basketball Wives, but at least it wasn't aggravating me and semi-boring me the way the shit was on Love & Hip Hop. But anyway, that's basically all that happened, y'all. I hope y'all like, comment, and subscribe, because this shit about to get hella fucking messy, okay, in the next coming episodes of Basketball Wives. It's about to get real messy, bitch. So I hope y'all come back and watch, all right? Mwah! Peace out. My mama, on my hood, I look fly, I look good, touch my swag, baby.